fear. The chemical supplied by a collective parasite creates a distinct bioelectric signal given off by the host. This signal is disseminated to the organisms within our community and will grow outward through the entire organism unless it is counterbalanced by an opposing force. Dr. Fritz Allen Popp discovered that the cells in our body communicate through biophotons, which are tiny particles of light that are single units of an electromagnetic field. This communication system within our body also exists between people in what's known as morphic resonance. This was known by the shamans, sages, and adepts of antiquity. These teachings were commonplace in prehistoric cultures. It wasn't by sheer chance that artistic expression and rituals were the cornerstone of every ancient civilization. Art was used as a personal method to exorcise the shadow content of the psyche and introduce it to the conscious mind. This was very literally viewed as psychic therapy. Ritual was based around astrological dates. As we've learned, the study of the stars and planets reflect our own astropsychology. The shamans would perform rituals on astrological dates that would correlate with a circadian rhythm or a psychological cycle. These rituals kept the human participants aware of their inner self and prevented the repression of psychological content. As long as people were facing their inner demons and accepting them as their own, they were not collectively projecting them into the physical world. If you bring forth what is within you, what you bring forth will save you. If you do not bring forth what is within you, what you do not bring forth will destroy you. The progeny of our psychological disease began growing rapidly after a series of catastrophes forced the collective into a somatic state of fight or flight. This lowered the immunity of the population by introducing a state of immense stress. Our body becomes more susceptible to illness under stress. In this manner, humanity fell ill when entire bodies of land were swallowed up by the floodwaters. This uprooted many tribes, chiefdoms, and civilizations from their homes, and their ritual practices that were used as a conduit for psychic wellness were put on hold in order to survive the catastrophe and seek new homes. The shamans were spread to many new areas of the world. This information has been suppressed. We are made to believe that advanced civilizations such as ancient Egypt and the Mayans of Mesoamerica came about with no prior rudimentary remnants or evidence of evolving intellectual artifacts to bring them to their peak. We are meant to believe that their incredible knowledge of mathematics, astrology, agriculture, economy, polity, and architecture came out of nowhere. This leads many researchers today to the understanding that the origins of these civilizations have been suppressed. These are some of the notable book burnings and suppression of important texts in our history. Yet after all of this suppression, there are still remnants of the dispersion of elder civilizations in nearly every country. There is tremendous evidence of ancient cultures visiting North America long before the conventional belief of European colonization. Barry Fell states in his book, America BC, there are ancient inscriptions now being reported from nearly all parts of the United States, Canada, and Latin America, written in various European and Mediterranean languages in alphabets that date from 2,500 years ago. William Commodus Beaumont wrote, "The Toltec and Maya civilizations never originated on American soil, but appeared there full-blown, with a well-defined art and system of hieroglyphic writing which possesses affinities with Egyptian." To suppress this information further, it was not only imperative for the bloodline to burn the documented texts containing true historical information, but to wipe out the cultures that derived from these ancient shamans. The most devastating genocide ever endured was and still is the annihilation of shamanic tribes.
We've lost our traditional roots and don't know about ritual. The dragon dances and the ghost dances of the Native American Indians, what do you think that was all about? All the shamans of the world, when they do their rituals, they're doing that. Their work, harmonically through dances, is to strengthen the immune system of the earth. You know, but they've been all murdered. So that was why it's in the 17th century, exactly the same period I'm talking about, there was an all-out agenda that when you come across indigenous people, you annihilate them.
resurrected in a way by one man who says he has discovered behind me here not only the first pyramid on the entire European continent, but the largest, biggest valley of pyramids in the entire world.
In only a few months of excavation, plenty of stonework has already been discovered. Samir used satellite, thermal, and topography analysis on tens of thousands of hills in his search for pyramids.
Instead of thousands of hills, we found nine of them. Five of them being located in this valley. You have perfect geometry and you have cardinal points. Once I saw that a year and a half ago, I immediately knew that this is not a naturally made hill, but man-made.
Archaeologists are making a fascinating discovery. Let's go to see that's Brooke Baldwin. She traveled to Mirador and came back with an amazing story. Brooke, tell our viewers what's going on.
Wolf, I think I'm officially an archaeology geek. Our CNN crew, we're the first TV camera actually in the world to shoot the face of what may be the world's largest pyramid by volume. This pyramid, it is covered by the canopy of the jungle. It is currently facing several threats. From the air, it looks like just jungle, but these forests in Guatemala hide an ancient secret. The city of Mirador, often referred to as the cradle of Mayan civilization, the size of a modern-day metropolis. This is no mountain. It's a pyramid, and according to the Mirador Basin Project, it may be the largest pyramid by volume in the world.
At the very end of the Japanese archipelago lies Yonaguni, shrouded in mist and mystery.
Several meters beneath the surface lies one of the world's greatest mysteries, a place that could, quite literally, rewrite human history. No one can be entirely sure what's down there, but many experts are convinced it's the remains of a vast and ancient underwater city, a lost civilization, a Japanese Atlantis.